Yeah, I get it. This isn't my normal video making style. Usually when we talk about free agents to be and upcoming players, we don't talk about them as if they're going to a team, and I don't really give my pitches as to why I think these players would be good for one certain team. Today we're talking about a free agent to be, and already I know this is going to be a video where Canucks fans and Habs fans and fans of other teams comment in my comment section, Lego, why are you singling out Detroit? This player would be great for my favorite team. You should talk about this player in general. Well, I wanted to spin it a little bit differently here today, so that's what we're doing. Today we're talking about Pius Suter, and it's spelt Pius Suter, but the way the Swiss commentators pronounce his name on the broadcasts, it's Pius Suter, kind of with an A instead of an R sound at the end. So we're gonna call him Suter for this video. But Pius Suter is a guy who, in my opinion, the Detroit Red Wings should absolutely be all over. In fact, most NHL teams should probably be all over this kind of player, but I'm singling out Detroit because of a few certain factors. Who exactly is this guy, and why are we talking about him in this way? Well, Pius Suter was the best Swiss player in the Swiss Hockey League this past season. He is a 24-year-old center left wing player, 5'11", 170 pounds, born in 1996. He was a guy who, because he was born in 96, his draft year was all the way back in 2014. But he was undrafted. In 2014, he played for the Guelph Storm, where he had 24 points in 66 games, so not exactly a number that people would say was a draft-worthy number. Up to that point, he had been playing mostly in Swiss junior leagues, and he made his way over to North America in the OHL, although with not as much success as people would have liked. His draft plus one season, though, saw him post up 72 points in 61 games for the same Guelph Storm team, and 43 goals. He was an absolute beast. He was okay at the World Juniors, but for the most part, it still wasn't enough to get him drafted. After that season, where he was 18 years old, he went back over to Switzerland and spent the rest of his career with the ZSC Lions. His immediate next season was playing with the same Lions team with Austin Matthews, so there's a nice connection over there. He had a few good years, he had a few worse years, but for the most part, Pius Suter was a guy who kind of exploded this most recent NLA season, where, as a guy who was 23 turning 24 years old, he had 53 points in 50 games played. He had 30 goals in that stretch too. As a Swiss national athlete, he had 9 points in 5 games played for Team Switzerland in the international tournaments, so that's certainly a really good number to have as well. The reason we're talking about Pius Suter here in this context is because recently he decided to exercise his NHL out clause with the ZSC Lions. His contract with the Lions goes until 2023. However, he has the ability to say, you know what? I love playing with you guys, but I want to go to the NHL. I'm going to use my NHL out clause and make a run for North America at any time. And it looks like now, as of yesterday, he is going to be exercising that option. Take a look at this article over here, translated to English from German on the ZSC Lions website. Pius has really earned this opportunity with his strong performance with the Lions. We, as an organization, wish him every success in the NHL. And strong performance, oh man, he had a really strong performance this past season. He was first in the entire league in goals, he was first in the entire league in points, he was the best forward, he was the MVP, and he just had such a good season, and when you watch the tape, you watch the highlights of this guy, you can totally see why. Pius Suter is a guy who was really energetic. He was always moving out there. Every time he had the puck, he was always pushing forward. He was kind of a player who didn't really give his opponents time to think or make a move, and when he didn't have the puck, he was always trying to find open space to give him for an opportunity at a good shooting lane. When he did get the puck, boy oh boy, he's got a quick release and an absolutely deadly wrist shot. His wrist shot, his one-timer, they combined for a good portion of his 30 goals this past season, and a lot of those other goals were scored on the rush. He's really good at shooting on the rush. His wrist shot is able to beat goaltenders at high speeds with accuracy, and because he moves pretty quickly out there on his feet, it certainly sets him up for some good scoring opportunities. He's a guy who I would define as slippery, because when he did have the puck or when he didn't, he would usually find ways to slip by guys to get his way to the front of the net. He had a lot of goals where he would just take the puck towards the goal, shove his way through there, and get it in by the goaltender that way too. He's an all-around guy who, honestly, I could totally understand watching the tape why he was the best player in the Swiss NLA. So why exactly am I saying that this guy should be going to Detroit? Well, because if you take a look at the impact that players like these can have, and you take a look at a team that could be a little bit more comfortable for this kind of player than others, I think Detroit could be that team. What we're taking a look at here is a player who was the best Swiss player going over to the NHL. The last time we saw this was literally a year ago, and that guy's name was Dominik Kubalík. Kubalík had 25 goals and 57 points in 50 games before going to the Chicago Blackhawks last year. Now, he did have more points than Suta, but Suta had more goals. And Kubalík displayed a really good ability this past season with the Blackhawks to get those goals. As a 24-year-old, Kubalík had 30 goals and 46 points in 68 games for the Blackhawks. It's why people are saying he's an underdog for that Calder Trophy. Well, Suta is a guy who does have a very equally good wrist shot and scoring ability, and he is going to be 24 once his next season starts up as well. So now that he's opening himself up to NHL teams, I think this should be a really good opportunity for Detroit to bounce on it. Why? Well, because his last season played in North America with the Guelph Storm in the OHL, where he had 72 points in 61 games. His line mates were Tyler Bertuzzi and Robbie Fabbri. Yeah, it's pretty great, isn't it? Two current Red Wings, one who was drafted and developed by Detroit, the other who was acquired in a trade, are the beloved line mates of Pius Suta when he had his best OHL season. Take a look at this. This is an article back from November of 2014. This was when Tyler Bertuzzi set the Guelph Storm record by recording 7 points in a 9-4 win over the London Knights. Just when they needed them the most, the Guelph Storm's top line trio of Tyler Bertuzzi, Robbie Fabbri, and Pia Suta came up big. So Pia Suta, who already has the line mate connection in Detroit, who is already a really good free agent player just based off of his track record, could honestly become a very valuable piece if the Red Wings decided, hey, you know, let's sign this guy. Which is why I'm making a pitch here. I don't normally make these kinds of videos where I connect teams with free agents, but this one just seems so perfect for a Red Wings team that is deprived of offense and one of the worst teams we have seen in the salary cap era. Now, am I dismissing the idea of other NHL teams going for this player? Of course not. There was a report, if you search up Pia Suta's name, the first article shows that the Blackhawks are currently in the mix for Suta, and that frankly does not surprise me in the slightest. The last Swiss free agent to do this whole process of coming over to the NHL, who was really good, again, we mentioned it was Kubalík, that was literally with the Blackhawks, so if Suta is going to get NHL interest, I would not be surprised if the Blackhawks were one of the top front bidders for that. But to me, Detroit should be that team, man. Reunite this line! Bertuzzi, Fabbri, Suta, really good players in the OHL who combined for a total of 200 plus points. Put them back together and we'll see what they're going to be able to do. Tyler Bertuzzi has been improving year after year. Robbie Fabbri came into the NHL with a little bit of uncertainties, but he came into the Red Wings system with a lot of confidence and hot streaks. And Suta is a guy who has just been improving his craft year after year in Switzerland and who was the best Swiss forward this past season. You know you want it, Red Wings fans. You know you want this kind of connection. So that's why I'm making my pitch over here. The Red Wings should do it. The Red Wings should be the team to sign him. I want to see this line reconnected, and I want to see success brought back to Detroit. So, talk to me in the comments below. Have I made my pitch? Does this look like a player you would see value in if the Red Wings signed? If you're not a Red Wings fan, have I made my pitch regardless? Is this a player that you think your team should go after? Because if I did my job correctly, you should be saying, you know what? no matter what team I'm cheering for, yes, the value in this kind of player looks to be tremendous. You don't know what you have in a guy like this. You could have a Kubalik, or you could have just another tweener who ends up in the AHL. You never know with these kinds of things, but the track record to me is enough for me to say I want the Red Wings to at least try taking a flyer on this kind of guy. So talk to me in the comments below what you think about this whole idea. I hope you enjoyed this video. So, 99, and bye.